Hello, welcome to episode 476 of Oatmeal Breakfast Play the Video Game. On this episode I played Pro Tennis World Court. This game is adorable. All the players that you can select are adorable. The courts are adorable. And the Japanese words that you read on the screen between the gameplay are adorable. The Japanese you hear when the ball is out, or there is a fault, or double fault, or you win a match, or set is adorable. I like this tennis game more than I liked the ZX Spectrum tennis game I played on an earlier episode of the show. I had great fun trying to serve the ball. You can't throw the ball up and hit it at any time you like and have it go in the court you are serving to. You hit the tennis ball too early and the ball will go out. You hit the ball too late on the serve and it will hit the net, and if you wait too long to hit the ball you will miss it completely. So I found serving to be very fun. When it was the computer's turn I had trouble returning the serve. I think I got better at that the more I played. When I first played this game I could not return a serve. In this video you will see me return a serve. So I think that Pro Tennis World Course is a nice tennis game. I also that I can play one set, or three. For this video I played one set. If I had played three sets this video would be probably 14 minutes long. Too long for my taste. Too much work for me. Haha. So I think, if you play Pro Tennis World Court you will have fun. What else do I want to talk about? When I was younger I used to watch a lot of tennis on television. I only remember a few of the players I watched. My favorite tennis player was Todd Martin. I think he had a beard at the time I watched him. I thought it was cool that he was 6 feet 6 inches tall. I don't know how many times I watched him. I did always like to watch him play. I used to watch Wimbledon and the French Open. I don't remember ever watching the US Open. I think I remember one time getting up early in the morning to watch the finals of Wimbledon. I sure would have liked to have some strawberries and cream while watching the finals. Let's see, John McEnroe and Chris Everett were announcers on the tennis matches I watched. That was years ago. I have not watched much tennis recently. I probably can't name any of the top tennis players. I felt so old. Playing Pro Tennis World Court made me think of tennis video games. I bet a tennis game on the PlayStation 5, or the Xbox One, or the Nintendo Switch look so realistic by now. I never had any tennis video games on any of the video game consoles I had. Which is weird to me, because I liked to watch tennis on television, so you think I would want to play a tennis video game. Why was I not into tennis video games as much as, say, basketball video games, or baseball video games? I had a lot of basketball games. At that time I had mostly football and basketball video games. But, no tennis. That confuses me. Back at that time probably my favorite sports were basketball, football, baseball and tennis. Yet no tennis video games. Oh, well. I don't know what tennis video games were popular on the console I had. They might not have been that fun to play or looked that good. I remember at school I used to like to hit a tennis ball against the wall of our tennis courts at school. That was fun. What else do I want to talk about? I want to also learn to juggle tennis balls. That would be fun. So I hope to juggle tennis balls soon. Is there anything else I can think of to say about tennis? I can't think of anything. This episode is a little longer than most, so I will have to think of more to write. So let me think. I watched RC Taylor's video, where they reviewed RC Jet Boat. As I was watching the video I thought I wonder if I would find driving an RC boat fun. Then I thought I wish I could put some markers in the water so I could try to drive the boat around them. I was thinking that if I did not have some kind of track or objects to drive the boat around, that driving an RC boat would not be fun. By the way, I have never owned an RC boat. I know that I would rather own an RC boat than a real boat. A real sized boat would be too much money. I would not want to play millions of dollars for a yacht. I never even gave owning an RC boat any thought when I was younger. There was not a lake that I could drive it on where I live. Though I am sure I could find water to drive a boat on if I had owned an RC boat. Maybe I would rather have a pontoon plane than a boat. Landing a plane on water has always seemed very cool to me. Maybe if I owned an RC boat I would freak out. What if it breaks down and I can't drive it to shore? I suppose I could jump in the water and get it. Or I could leave it in the water and go buy a new RC boat. Maybe one day I will own an RC boat. I don't know. What else am I going to think of to talk about? Maybe I would like to have an RC submarine. I could use it to see what is under the water. Now that would be fun. I would worry, well, what if it stops working? How am I going to get it back? I suppose I could buy cheap RC submarines, and then if I lose them it would not be that big of a deal. So I am almost to the end of this episode. It must be amazing to have a YouTube channel as popular as Kevin Talbot and to get that many views on each video. Wow, I have got a long way to go to get that popular. Thank you for watching this video. Have an amazing day. Have a super day. Bye, bye.